Good morning, and welcome to the Lebanon Congregational Church. We are at our second Sunday of Easter and are continuing to celebrate Jesus' resurrection. Today is also our annual Heavenly Humor Sunday, and with that, I would like to start us off with a joke today. A Sunday school teacher was asking her six-year-olds about the meaning of Easter. "Children," she said, "do you know why we celebrate Easter?" A little girl raised her hand. "Yes, Jenny," said the teacher. Jenny said, "In Easter is when we put on costumes and go trick-or-treating." "No, Jenny, that's Halloween. Does anyone else know?" A little boy yells, "It's when we set off fireworks." "No, Jimmy, that's Independence Day. Anyone else?" A shy little girl in the back says, "Easter is when Jesus died." The teacher replied, "That's right, Shauna. And what happened to Jesus that makes Easter special?" "Well, he died and got buried. And every Easter he comes out, and if he sees his shadow, there's six more weeks of winter." With that, we'll share if there are any announcements. And I do have one to share. So I would like to remind everyone that on April 17th, the Lebanon FFA will be doing a spring breakfast of takeout. The details are in your bulletin, so please read your bulletin for that announcement as others. And if there are any other announcements, we'll hear them now.
Good morning. Ellen Meserol, clerk of the church, here to read the warning for the annual meeting. To the members of the First Congregational Church of Lebanon, Connecticut, the members of the First Congregational Church of Lebanon are hereby duly warned of the annual meeting to be held on April 18th, 2021, following the church service. The annual meeting will be held for the purpose of A, approving the 2020 annual reports from the church officers, boards, and committees, B, electing church officers, boards, delegates, and committees for 2021. C, considering and acting upon the 2021 annual budget. D, other business which may be rightfully brought before the church membership. Signed, Ellen Meserol, clerk of the church.
And now we'll turn the service over to Reverend Will. Thank you. Have a great day.
Good morning and welcome to the First Congregational Church of Lebanon, United Church of Christ. I'm the Reverend Dr. Will Sensaba, and I am the pastor here at this congregation. So very glad that you have decided to join us worship at this time. This morning, our worship service is going to be centered around Holy Humor Sunday. That's right, the ancient tradition that has long been practiced of celebrating Holy Humor Sunday on the Sunday after Easter. Easter. The resurrection experience where God gets the last laugh. And so we're going to have some fun, hopefully, in the service today. I also want to let you know that this morning in our in-person worship service, we'll be having a baptism, and we'll be celebrating the sacrament of baptism. And so what we're going to do during that service is we're going to record it, and it will actually be a part of next week's worship service. So you'll be able to watch that happen next week's service. Again, I'm so very glad that you are here on this Holy Humor Sunday. Hopefully the music, the words will lift your spirit and bring joy to your life, joy into your heart on this Holy Humor Sunday. Again, welcome. Thank you.
We come every day to the waters of baptism.
We come to wash away the clutter of our lives.
We come to wash away our prejudice, our anger, our despair.
We come every day to the waters of baptism. We come wondering, what is preventing us from accepting this new life?
Hey, Julie.
What?
Did you hear about the invisible man who married the invisible woman?
No.
Yeah, their kids aren't much to look at either.
Hey, Will, what do you call a boomerang that doesn't work?
I don't know, Julie. What do you call a boomerang that doesn't work?
Stick.
Hey, why did the cookie visit the doctor?
I don't know.
Because he felt crummy.
Hey, Will, why do you not say 288 in polite conversation?
I don't know, Julie. Why don't you say 288 in polite conversation?
Because it's too gross.
Did you hear about the two antennas that got married?
No.
Yeah, the wedding was terrible, but the reception was great.
Hey, Will, did you hear about the dyslexic devil worshiper?
Dyslexic devil worshiper? No.
He sold his soul to Santa.
Take time to be funny. Rejoice in the Lord. Let laughter explode and have fun with God's word. Laughter is healing, gives strength to the weak. God loves to see smiles, for they lift up the meek. For humor is holy, it sanctifies life, replenishes hope, and oft softens advice. Undercuts sorrow, deflates haughty pride. So smile and hang on, and rejoice in life's ride. Amen.
Prayer of Invocation. God of dreams and visions, you whisper your yearning into our sleeping hours, inspiring us with greater hope than we can imagine. You beckon us to listen closely at the strangers who enter our waking hours, alerting us to your voice, asking questions we have not thought to ask. Help us to hold fast to the visions and to pay attention to the unfamiliar wisdom. Help us to remember that our baptism was and is and always will be an immersion in the living waters of your creative power, demanding a wholehearted commitment to be made anew, over and over and over. Amen.
Two boll weevils grew up in South Carolina. One went to Hollywood and became a famous actor. The other stayed behind in the cotton fields and never amounted to much. The second one naturally became known as the lesser of two weevils.
Two men were discussing how much they knew about religion, each boasting he knew more than the other. Finally, to prove his superiority, one said, "I bet you can't say the Lord's Prayer." "Well, I'll take that bet," the other man said. "Now I lay me down to sleep," he proudly proclaimed. The challenger looked at him in amazement and said, I didn't think you knew it.
The clerk of the church board continually opposed the pastor's proposal to get a new chandelier for the church. Finally, the pastor took her aside and asked her why she always blocked his proposal. The clerk told him three reasons. One, I can't spell it for the minutes. Two, we don't have anyone who can play one of those things. And three, what we really need is a new light fixture for the sanctuary.
Brother. A pastor was invited to dinner. During the meal, he was astonished to hear the young daughter say that people must be very brave to go to the church these days. The pastor asked the little girl, "Why would you say that?" The girl responded, "I heard Dad tell Mom last Sunday that there was a big shot in the pulpit, a loose cannon in the vestry, the choir murdered the anthem, and the organist drowned everybody."
An elderly man who had been fitted with a hearing aid a week earlier returned to the doctor's office for a checkup. "How do you like the hearing aid?" the doctor asked. "Fine," replied the patient. "How does the family like it?" the doctor inquired. "Oh, I haven't told them yet," the patient answered, "but I've changed my will three times."
The tourist goes onto a bar and there's a dog sitting in a chair playing poker. He says, "Is that dog really playing poker?" And the bartender says, "Yeah, but he's not too good. Whenever he has a good hand, he starts wagging his tail."
Sunday, the congregation enters in. There's a deacon at the podium, and then the service begins. They say, "Now, are there any announcements?" And the clerk says, "You know the drill. There's a meeting next week. It's a quorum we seek." Then we turn it over to Reverend Will. Oh, la da 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 da. La da 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 da. Sing us a song, the other piano man. Sing us a song today. We're not supposed to sing along with you, but we'll probably hum anyway. Now Reverend Will leads us in worship from atop pulpit stairs, looking down at the people. Bells ring from the steeple, thinking, "Man, this church really cares." He says, "Derek, please play me a melody. I'm sure you know how it goes. And the cross we all face in this sacred place. Praise God from whom all blessings flow." La da 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 da. La da 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 da. The candles are lit on the altar, and we join together in praise. Then we listen a while as Will preaches in style, a sermon to astound and amaze. This year, it's been a long one, but we've gotten each other through. Apart but not alone, this church is built on stone and will stand through all that we do. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song today. We're not supposed to sing along with you, but we'll probably hum anyway. This beautiful day, and many watching online, 'cause we've all heard a rumor, today's holy humor, and laughter is better than wine. Now that's a pun, get it? So this parody I wrote for all of you, I sure hope it makes you proud, 'cause God loves you, and there's nothing you can do, so laugh much, laugh often, laugh loud. La da 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 da. La da 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 da. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing because you can. 'Cause you know that we are all wondering, when will you play the organ again?
Now time for the Church at Prayer. And I'm going to invite you to remember all of those for whom laughter and joy seems so far away, such a remote possibility, that there are so many who are struggling at this time. And I invite you to remember those folks in your prayers, not only at this time, but certainly in the days to come. And we thank God this morning for the joy that we do have in our lives, where we can find it, when we can find it, where we can find those people, and when we can spend time with those people who bring joy into our lives. So I'm going to offer a prayer and then invite you to join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Gracious, loving God, you bring joy into our lives in so many ways. We can see the signs of spring all around us. We can see new life bursting and blooming around us. And it brings a smile to our face. It fills our hearts with joy. And we thank you, God. We ask and pray, God, that you be with all of those who are struggling at this time, and that they might be able to find joy in their lives. And help us to be agents of your peace, agents of your grace, ambassadors for Christ, with all of those who cross our path. We ask and we pray for these things in the name of your Son, our Lord, our Savior, our great joy, Jesus the Christ, who taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
A pig walked into a bar, ordered 15 beers, and drank them. The bartender asked, "Would you like to know where the bathroom is?" "No," said the little pig. "I'm the little pig that goes wee, wee, wee all the way home."
Today's scripture reading comes from John 20, verses 19 through 31. Jesus appears to the disciples. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As Father has sent me, I so send you." When he had said this, he had breathed on them, and they said to him, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they have forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the marks of the nails in his hands, and put my fingers in the marks of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again at the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood amongst them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name.
Tommy the twin. That's what he was called growing up. See, Jesus and Thomas were blood brothers growing up. And they would walk to school and they learned the Torah together. They'd wander off from time to time in the hills near Nazareth. And Thomas and Jesus were so close that people referred to them as the twins. There are a few things about Tommy that are worth mentioning. First, he wasn't the brightest bulb in the flower bed. He had a knack for saying and doing the wrong thing. And he was almost always never around when the fun and exciting thing happened. Jesus and Thomas, they used to go out exploring, looking for lost treasure. One day they try to find Noah's Ark, sure that it must be over the next hill. but they never found it. However, one day, when Jesus and Biff went out, they found it. And then they went to tell Thomas about it. But then the next time that Jesus and Thomas went out to go find it, it was gone. He missed it. And they were never able to find it again. The others quickly realized that Tommy was a little gullible. Jesus and Tom were sitting on a roof one day, and they were both going to jump off of the roof. And so Thomas went first, and he jumped off, but he died in the fall. But being best friends with Jesus certainly has its perks, because Jesus brought him back to life again. Well, it wasn't long before Tommy's parents forbade him from ever hanging out again with that bad influence, Jesus. So they separated for some time, and it wasn't until after they had learned their trades that Tommy ran into Jesus again. This time, Jesus was saying and doing some pretty awesome things. See, Jesus had left his carpentry gig to enter into ministry full time. And the old friendship was rekindled, and they were like two peas from the same pod. Jesus and Thomas, so much alike that they were like twins. The others worried about Thomas, and they tried to help him along, but it seems like every time something important happened, Thomas was off doing something else. Like the Transfiguration. Who was at the Transfiguration? Peter, James, John. Well, Tommy was supposed to be there, but he was attending a get-rich-quick seminar. However, it turned out to be just a pyramid scheme, which is ironic because it was investing in pyramids in Egypt. He missed the wedding in Cana, you know, the one where Jesus turned water into wine, because he went jackalope hunting with Judas. And it took him all day before he realized there was no such thing as a jackalope. I mean, how could Judas betray him like that? The other disciples, oh, they really got a kick out of that one. He missed the Sermon on the Mount because he was promised a free 4-day, 3-night cruise around the Dead Sea by only attending a timeshare seminar. He did buy some waterfront property in Sodom, but that's only because they threw in Gomorrah. A little known fact was that he was kicked out of the upper room and missed most of the Last Supper. And Mary Magdalene, she had to step in as Jesus's plus one. Just before they started to eat, the others waited as Tommy filled his mouth with lamb. And as soon as he did, one of the others said, "Hey, Tommy, why don't you say a blessing for the food?" And they were always messing with Tommy, playing practical jokes, right? Pulling out his cushion before he sat down and putting a whoopee cushion on top of another cushion. And when everyone else was drinking wine, they'd put water in his glass and say something like, "Oh, looks like Jesus turned it back." Apparently, at the supper, he started to recruit for direct marketing. Amway. And the others had had enough of that. And so they politely asked him to leave. They would tell him the tale of all of the things that he missed. Jesus walked on water. Jesus healed this guy. He restored the sight of that one. He forgave this lady of her sins. And Thomas was like, "Okay, sure, sure." So naturally, when Jesus kept telling them that they were going to go to Jerusalem and he was going to be crucified, Thomas just went along. Tommy figured this was going to be Jesus and the gang's biggest practical joke yet. Sure. Of course you're going to die and you're going to come back from the dead. So Tommy went along with the joke. After all, this is exactly what they'd been doing to him all along. This is no different.
Jesus had said so many things that could have come across as blasphemous. Even the Palm Sunday parade went a little too far. So when Judas conspired to betray Jesus, Thomas went along. When Peter denied Jesus, Thomas went along. When Jesus stood trial, Thomas watched, amazed at the theatrics and the commitment of so many people who were in on this giant practical joke. And Thomas sat there thinking, wow, they are really trying to get me. So imagine Thomas's surprise when he watched in the distance the actual crucifixion of Jesus, his blood brother, his twin. This was no joke. This was real. Or was it? Was it a joke? Could Jesus now do for himself what he had done for all these other people? Could he actually perform a last second miracle? He could save everyone else. Surely he could save himself. If this was a joke, though, where were the others? Why were they not standing behind a rock somewhere, ready to jump out, laughing? But they'd all disappeared. They were gone. This is real. No joke. A few days later, it was the Passover and the Sabbath. It was Sunday. And he decided to go back to the room where he last dined with his mates. And he would apologize for his social blunder, and he'd say goodbye to his friends. There wasn't much left for him in Palestine. He'd traveled to India. He always wanted to go there. And now there was really nothing keeping him but bitter memories. So of course, Thomas was a little late, and all the others were already there, except Judas. Tommy was late because he was busy picking up his newest entrepreneurial venture, t-shirts that read, "I followed Jesus for 3 years, and all I got was this lousy t-shirt." But when he got to the upper room, the door was locked. Of course it was, right? At first he thought, this was just the gang trying to be funny. But then it occurred to him, no, they went after Jesus. Now they're coming after us. So he rapped the secret knock, and then he waited. And when he went in, oh, they spun this incredible story about Jesus coming back and talking to them. But then Jesus had to leave again. So I guess you could say that Thomas missed the original Grateful Dead show. Thomas had had enough of their practical jokes and their Chicken Little baloney. He was done. He was traumatized. He didn't know what to believe. If Jesus was dead, then this is the horrible joke. If he was alive, then this Passover plot is the greatest practical joke of all time. If he was alive, and this is news to them too, then Jesus is the real deal. I tell you what, Thomas said not so confidently. If Jesus steps in here right now and I can actually stick my fingers in the holes on his hands and his side, then I'll believe. So Thomas is either an outlier or the most practical and authentic one of the bunch. He did meet Jesus, and he did believe, and he did go to India, and he spread the gospel of Jesus Christ throughout India and converted the multitudes until eventually Thomas was martyred. And that
is no joke. Amen.
Hey, Will.
Yeah, Julie.
Why did the banker break up with his girlfriend?
I don't know, Julie. Why did the banker break up with his girlfriend?
Because he lost interest.
Okay, so these two cannibals are eating a clown, and one says to the other one, "Does this taste funny to you?"
Why are there so many Smiths in the phone book?
I don't know, Julie. Why are there so many Smiths in the phone book?
Because they all have phones.
Did you hear about the restaurant on the moon?
No, I didn't.
Oh, the food is out of this world, but there's no atmosphere.
How many Congregationalists does it take to screw in a light bulb?
I don't know, Julie. How many Congregationalists does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Five. One to screw in the light bulb, and four to talk about how much they miss the old one.
Yep. How many telemarketers does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Oh.
Only one, but they have to do it while you're eating dinner.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Don't let anyone blow it up. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, don't let anyone blow it up. I'm gonna let it shine. Don't let anyone blow it up. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Amen.
May God fill you with joy on this day. May God fill your life with love and laughter. And may the people that cross your path bring a smile to your face and grace and mercy into your life. The same grace and mercy that our resurrected Lord Jesus Christ has shown and promised and given to each and every one of us. Let the joy of Christ be with you now and all of your days. Amen.
Did you hear that Willie Nelson got hit by a car?
Willie Nelson got hit by a car?
Yeah, he was playing On the Road Again.
Oh my gosh. So Julie,
Why did the Amish couple get divorced?
Ooh, I don't know.
He was driving her buggy.
Hey, well, why are all the toilet seats were stolen from the police station?
All they were?
The police had nothing to go on.
So bad. Did you hear about the Buddhist who refused Novocaine during his root canal?
No.
He wanted to transcend dental medication.
Yeah. So a man walks into a restaurant and says, "How do you prepare your chickens?" The cook says, "Nothing special. We just tell them they're gonna die." Oh.
That was dark. They get dark.
Really dark.
All right, we're gonna lighten the mood here. What's the difference between Baptists and Congregationalists?
I don't know.
Baptists won't wave to each other at the liquor store.